Look, I played the game, I missed the shot. I had the answer, then forgot. I knew one day my pop finance, for now, flexing, I fell out and cut the chip. Monopolize the set, but I've been taking hits like I can die like any. One of the day, the dawn of the dead day. I don't see nothing but red. I gather the blankets and milk and the bread. I come from the east and I'm traveling west. Got a machete, I chopping. The nigga, the server, determined, the plot and the threats. It ain't no stopping and run. Popping, son of God, dropping anybody who next. I want a mansion, I got a million advances. I'm gonna stay in Atlanta. Most of them move to LA and throw all of their money away and move back with their parents. I see the canvas, I got the. Are mixing again, grabbing a stick with my hand. I drop my gush. The world is us. So what? Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust.
It's week 9 of the NFL, and today's clash of conferences is just moments away. It's the Falcons and the Broncos, and it's coming up next on EA Sports.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL has us at the foot of the Rockies, just west of downtown Denver, at Power Field at Mile High. A moment ago, through a shower of pyrotechnics, it was the hometown Broncos taking the field as they get set to do battle with the Atlanta Falcons. Charles Davis. And Charles, we look at this Bronco team. They come in the midst of a pretty bad stretch here. Losers are 5 straight.
So many different reasons teams hit the losing skids, but the best way out of it, something has to happen positive early in the game.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Falcons, they too were losers last week, so they're also hoping to get back in the win column.
Something's got to give in this one, right? Both teams want to start a new streak, and they both want it to be a victory. This should be a fun one.
From Denver. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30, right about the 29. So here are the Broncos now for their opening drive. At a glance at the man under center at 6'5", he always demands attention.
And I'll bet right now it's just one thought in his mind.
Win the game.
Oh, yeah, without a doubt. He played pretty well. I mean, he didn't turn over the ball in terms of interceptions,
right? Two touchdown passes last week.
Two touchdown passes, but when your team doesn't win, that's just hollow. And the best quarterbacks don't care about anything but whether or not their team won.
Here's the first carry for Austin Ekeler. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Calling no gain on the game's first play, and it's second down now. Looking to throw. Brown into the secondary, past the 40. And he'll finally be taken down just shy of midfield.
Bring it!
Oh, that was a nice job there. Quarterback and receiver reading the pressure that was brought. They both knew it was going to open up the middle of the field. Nice little shake and bake at the line of scrimmage, got right into his route. And the quarterback hit him in stride, and he was able to run free after the catch.
Now here's a throw right side, taken in by his tight end. He was locked in. Two trips to the end zone, Charles, over 100 yards receiving.
How about the combination of route running, confidence going downfield, and the ability to go up and get the football? You're exactly right. It was hard for them to stop him.
They run for the first time with Javonte Williams. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
Just a terrific run there, Charles, from a running back who is so compact and powerful, and that strength was on display there.
Yeah, and this could be a sign of what this defense is in for, because you know all week long the coaches were preaching to the defense, you've got to be able to wrap up against a back like him, or he can make you pay. Technique, technique, technique.
And you can see the distance traveled there after the initial contact on the next-gen stats. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Back to throw. Brown. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
And Charles, you wonder about this defense coming in. I mean, look, it's no secret they're playing a team that's down on its luck right now. Losers of five straight. How does that change how you prepare for a game?
Well, to me, the first thought is you just get after them early, right? Take away any chance of them building any confidence. But the second thing is you prepare a little bit differently. You've got to expect this team to take chances, go for it on third and fourth downs, run a lot of trick plays, anything to try and break their losing streak. So you must stay alert and stay aware.
Gonzalez's kick is good. And the Broncos, the first to grace the scoreboard. It's 3-0. In the end, the opening drive, Charles, does yield points. Maybe not the touchdown that they wanted, though.
Yeah, but bottom line, they wanted to get something out of that drive, and they did that. 3 points, they won't turn that down at all.
After the field goal, here's Gonzalez to kick it off. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. So here come the Falcons now to get the football for the first time. And they will be led out by their 6'6" quarterback.
And he made both sides happy last week, didn't he?
3-3.
I mean, his guys, they caught 3 touchdown passes, but he threw 3 interceptions. Gotta get off of that schneid and get back to just throwing touchdown passes and taking care of the ball better.
Play fake here on first down. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Martin. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there? Freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Second and 4. From the gun, Peck, and he rifles one incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap. He locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
Now they face a third down and 4 after that incompletion on second down.
He's going to have the hookup here to Chase,
and he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down. I think defensively, you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. I don't know if I agree with that. I guess they don't care if I agree with that. But, boy, you have to be surprised by that, right?
I definitely was surprised that they decided to go for it in this situation. But they must have either felt like they either had a great play call on or they're trying to show extreme confidence.
And this call will be intercepted. Picked off by Justin Simmons. And the Broncos are going to have it here at their own 9-yard line. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3.
Out of the gun, Eckler running it. And they'll get him down here at the 23.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Running on first down, Eckler takes this to the 27, give him 4 yards.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
On second down, Eckler. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. We'll step aside and get a report when we come back to Denver. Here's Brown from the gun on third down. And that is incomplete. Oh, he did everything but hold on to it. But a nice play defensively, and now it brings up fourth down. On fourth down, here's Brett Kern to punt the football away. Only 2 punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. And they'll go ahead and down this one right on the chalk of the 20-yard line. So for the second time in this one, we get set to see the Falcons' offense. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I'm hearing my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
Good work, D. That's how we play.
A lot of bad news on that play for them, wasn't there? Lost the football, lost a lot of yardage, but I think the good news outweighs it. Able to retain possession. That was big for them.
Now some movement before the snap. And we'll hear from our referee for the first time this afternoon. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. So the false start certainly doesn't help matters as they'll try again now, third and long. From deep in their own territory, they look to throw. He's going to fire this thing deep right sideline. It got his man complete. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. A big play that time through the air. 33 yards. So the challenge there does not go their way. This will indeed remain a completed pass. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. It's picked up by the Broncos. And this is going to be brought back for a Denver touchdown. Second time he's lost a fumble. This one hurts more. It's returned for 6.
He's been under a lot of duress, hasn't he? Pressure, hurry, harassed the whole game.
And the offensive line not giving him a lot of help.
Not a lot of help, but the bottom line, he's got to take care of the football.
Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT. And the lead grows to 10-0. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line.
And in just about every game we see, partner, what do? When we look at the stat sheet, we go right to
the turnover differential,
without a doubt, because when we see that,
and this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. A big connection on that one. 34 yards. 10-0 the score after one on EA Sports. I'm not sure he saw the linebacker there, as that's batted down and incomplete.
And that's a nice job there, because you got to play the ball, not the man when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties, and he's able to knock that one away.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Off the bootleg, Peck rolling to his left. And give him 10 that time as he was able to get away from the pressure and get a nice gain.
So in this case, you'd think the defense would be collapsing to the left side of the field, and they forced him to his left. So he just tucked it away and picked up some yardage.
Open man is Chase, complete.
And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27.
That time the conversion comes courtesy of the RPO.
And know what it did? It moved the sticks. Nice pickup on third down. Even better decision.
And only a yard this time as he's taken down right around the 26.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
Jamar Chase, the intended receiver.
And it's third down.
You and I watched film yesterday, and you told me to watch his feet. For whatever reason, his footwork just looked off on that throw.
And you always love it when an ex-defensive back talks quarterback mechanics, right?
Well, but you're good at it.
Well, I try, all right? I don't know how good I am, but it doesn't take much to tell. His mechanics are off a little bit, exactly what you described. Footwork, that led to the incompletion.
And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line.
Yeah, these are the types of plays they're going to need to hit on if they're going to get back into this game. It hasn't been the greatest of first halves, but this is a nice throw here on third down, and they keep the drive going.
They'll roll him out right. And that is caught. Touchdown, Falcons.
Jamar Chase
with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Falcons have cut it to within a score. Two able to connect on the extra point, and the lead is down to a field goal. So that drive goes 8 plays, and the end result, an Atlanta touchdown.
Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
So here are the Broncos to take over on offense. They've dropped 5 straight coming in, so right now cherishing this lead. And they've got the football as well, 1st and 10. Throwing to start the drive, Brown. And he's going to have the hook up to Sutton. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
They'll run out of the gun with Eckler. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line.
2nd and 1 is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
Now Brown on 1st down. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. A gain of 6 there on 1st. On the give, this is Eckler. And he'll take this one up close to about the 45. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 3. They'll try to pick up the first with Eckler.
And he's going to have a Broncos 1st down as he's got this up to the 45-yard line.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Sutton. And he'll be out just a yard or 2 shy of the 30.
That's a pretty throw right there. That ball's in the air a long time, but it's right on the money on the right sideline. A really good route. Moving the defenders towards the middle of the field before breaking to the sideline. What a completion there. Big time arm strength. Very nice route.
Brown now on 1st and 10. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. A long way to go here on third down for the eighth play of the drive. Looking to throw, Brown. And he's got his man on the out route. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. It'll be a gain of eight, but it'll also lead to a fourth down. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. From the left hash, this from 53 yards out. Gonzalez's kick is good. And the lead stretches to six here. It's 13-7. That was perfect. From distance, he steps up, knocks it right down Main Street.
And Main Street's celebrating right now with him, aren't they? I love the mechanics of the whole thing. Snap, hold, everything was right on target, and the blocking was perfect, and he executed so, so well.
And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
There he is, the man taking the snaps under center, heading out for the next possession. He's had a solid start to this game, but bottom line is they're losing, so he doesn't care about his stats. He just wants to right the ship on the scoreboard.
He wants to actually increase his stats because he feels like if he does, that means things will get better for his team, maybe get them back into the ball game or into the lead. In these situations, I remember playing with a quarterback once where he actually ran out onto the field first ahead of everyone else just to say, guys, let's go. Try and create that energy, create that spark.
Well, so far he has one touchdown, one interception. He'll be looking for that second touchdown now. One play has him up past the 40 already and another first and 10. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked off by Kyle Fuller. And the Broncos are going to take over a couple of yards shy of midfield. Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question because when he gets to the sidelines, the coach is going to check on it, his teammates are going to check on it. Because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, because two interceptions for him in college and a half, I mean, that just didn't happen.
Good, strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
They try to set up the screen. Oh, nearly disaster. But it's incomplete. Not much chance of that working. Almost intercepted. It's second down. Now second and 10. To throw again, Brown. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down. So now third and 10. They had the big play to start the drive, but two incompletions since. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. This is swung out to Eckler, and he is out of bounds inside the 30. He did his best to just get four out of that, but not enough, and now fourth down. So now here comes the field goal team for the third time today. From the right hash, this from 44 yards out. Gonzalez's kick is good, and now it's a two-score game at 9-16-7. So he's been a busy man here in this first half. That's three field goals for him now.
And not just three field goals, but three for three. So even though the offense has struggled a bit putting it in the end zone, they've still been able to come away with points due to his leg.
And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And with a little under a minute remaining, they may try to put something together here just to try to cut into that deficit. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. First down now, but that clock rolling. Top operating from the gun. Peck.
Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
His defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
Off the play fake. Peck. Going up top. And that going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Off play action, Peck. Ball hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on third down.
The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. They'll try and throw for it here. Open target here, Darius Slayton. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. We now proceed to the start of the second half. Okay, Coach, thanks as always to you and the gang in Orlando as we welcome everyone back in for quarter number three. Broncos with a lead, and they will be receiving this kickoff here as quarter three is underway. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And they're still very much in this game, although they do trail. What's the game plan, Charles, for the second half?
It might be a little counterintuitive because most people will think losing equals passing the ball more, but I'd establish the running game. They kind of went away from it in the first half. I think if they get back in balance, it'll help them when they put the ball back in the air.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Now a give, Akers running left. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what'll be a third and 4. Really good stop there by the end in this 4-3 defense.
And not just pass rushers anymore, are they? Those guys can use their hands, control the point of attack, shed those blockers, and go get those ball carriers.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much since. Off the play fake. Peck. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sat back at the 38. He could not get away that time, and it'll be a loss of 11 on third down.
So if we recount real quick, he had the touchdown earlier, and now he comes up with the sack here. No doubt about it, he's having himself a game.
He's going to fire one deep over the middle, and it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it, and the Broncos will take over on downs. Denver offense at the line, ready to go. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever known.
And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. A handoff, it's Eckler. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. Second and 6.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
Brown to throw on second down.
And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Carlos Basham. What an effort from him on that play. Big tackle for a loss of 11. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. 14 yards is the pickup there, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
And I believe that that gain on third and long changes things quite a bit, because this would be a very long field goal. I wouldn't be surprised to see him go for it here.
On is Kern, the punter, to send this one away. And that hits at the six and carries into the end zone for a touchback. Atlanta regains possession of the football. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on four, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into.
And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Picked off by Kyle Fuller. And the Broncos are going to get the football here at their own 23. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now three interceptions in this ballgame.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning. Threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How things turn out for him?
I think okay. He's a guy in all the commercials now, right?
Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. They'll run here with Eckler. And he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a three-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough.
Under pressure, and down he goes. That winds up pushing him back 11 yards on the sack. And that'll bring up third.
Like how they've started the third quarter here. They force a punt on the first drive, and after this sack, it looks like they'll be forcing another one as well.
Absolutely. Maybe got their second win coming out of the locker room. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we've played three quarters. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. That is taken in by the tight end Fant. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark, because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. Once more, here's Eckler. And pretty good running as he'll be close to a first down at the Falcons 41. 52 yards on the ground for him so far. The Broncos on third down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. They need just a yard here. It's third and one. Now room for Eckler. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. Austin Eckler. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Broncos add on to their lead, and they appear poised to break this long losing streak. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. And this time he'll be stopped short of the goal line. He might have been out of gas after the long run. In any event, the try for two fails. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. Here comes the Atlanta offense now, ready to take over here. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A big play that time through the air. 34 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
And that is incomplete.
I like the thought process there. They connected on a big play, and sometimes you find the defense vulnerable. So they went for the bigger shot, went for it all on that one. This time, they were ready for it.
Off play action. Peck, he'll buy some time right. Now he's going to throw deep right side. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. And that is incomplete. That pass just a little bit off. It looked like maybe he tried to force it in there.
Game speed, always different no matter what you do in practice. You can't simulate it, right? So your decision making, everything has to be a little bit quicker. Sometimes it can throw you off until you adjust.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. He will find his man Chase complete. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. They'll run on first down with Akers. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Cam Akers with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Falcons get a bit closer. Extra point by Koo, up and good, as this gets him back within a touchdown and a two-point conversion. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. Now an injury stoppage here, and it's Javonte Williams who's clearly having some issues down there. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They started on the ground with Eckler. We'll step aside and get a report when we come back to Denver. 103 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down. It's Eckler again. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one that's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation. Paramount, and he got it done.
Hold on to that ball. So it's Bronco football as we get you reset here. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. This is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. Back to throw. Brown. And he's got his man in stride. Complete. They get 7 there, but it brings up 4th. I hate to surrender the football when you're nursing a slim lead, but they're going to have to punt it away. Trust that defense.
It's the right play at this stage of the game as well. You don't need to press it here because you do have that little bit of a cushion and you count on your D to make it stand up.
And he couldn't get it to check up. That kicks all the way into the end zone for a touchback. So all eyes on the Falcons. Down on the scoreboard. And time, a huge factor. How will this thing pan out? We'll watch as they come up on first down. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. Late game, that hurts. Take the touchdown off the board.
No doubt about it, and this is where you make a great movie scene, right? Go in, rally the team. Okay, we lost points there. Let's get it back and go out and score again. Can he get it done?
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today.
Picked off by Pat Surtain.
And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line.
Well, you just kind of feel for him right now. Four interceptions, and you can almost see through his face mask. There's a lot going on in between the ears.
There certainly is, and probably way too much, because now he's probably doubting himself a little bit, wondering what adjustments he has to make. But here's what he needs to do. Get through this game. Go to the press conference. Meet it head on and show your teammates you're ready to shoulder what happened today, and you'll be ready for the next game.
And if he can do that as a rookie, that's a great sign of maturity.
Now Eckler. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. And Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to fit,